Hi students, welcome to yet another session of my class. We are discussing novella Chronicle of Death Foretold by Gabriel Garcia Marquez. Let us continue the summary of our novella, chapter 2. I think all of you understand chapter 1. And I already told you in the first chapter itself that this the narration of the story is not in a chronological order. From the first chapter itself, we readers get the idea that Santiago Nasser is responsible for Angela Vigerio's disgrace. As a result, this Angela Vigerio's brothers, twin brothers, killed Santiago Nasser. And that important idea, that is the important incident in this novella, that we get from the first chapter itself. Then chapter 2. In the chapter 2, yes, the narrator is here. Narrator describes about Bayardo San Roman, that is Angela's husband, and how he became the husband of Angela Vigerio. That means the story that that has happened 6 months back. So the narration or the development of the plot is not in a chronological order. Here in this chapter, chapter 2, the narrator tells the story of Bayardo San Roman, that is the bridegroom of Angela Vigerio. He arrives in that particular town in August, that is 6 months before his wedding, that is marriage with Angela Vigerio. And about Bayardo San Roman, he is about 30 years old, younger, handsome guy, because he has a slim waist and golden eyes. And he says he has come to find someone to marry. That's why he arrived in the town. He first sees Angela when she is crossing the town square with her mother. First sight, that is Bayardo San Roman. He first sees Angela when she is crossing the town square with her mother, dressed in clothes of mourning. That was the first sight. And the two of them are carrying baskets of artificial flowers, that is Angela and her mother. And the second time Bayardo sees her, she is singing out the numbers of a raffle at a town event. That was the second sight. That is when That is, she is singing out the numbers to a raffle at a town event. And in that musical event, he buys all of the raffle tickets. This Bayardo San Roman, he buys all of the raffle tickets and wins a gift box, that is music box. And he has delivered this music box as a gift to Angela Vigerio. And that day was a special day in her life. That means that was her birth. That day was her birthday. But she never discovers how he found out it was her birthday. But he gave that musical box as a gift to Angela on her special day, that is on her birthday. And about Vigerio family, that is Angela's family. The Vigerios are a family of scant resources. I already told you her father, Poncio Vigerio, is a goldsmith and has lost his sight from doing so much work. Then Purisima del Carmen, that is Angela's mother, had been a school teacher until she married to this man. And Angela is the youngest and the prettiest of the family. And Pura Vigerio wants Bayardo San Roman to identify himself properly to gain her approval, and he introduces his whole family. This Bayardo San Roman, he is highly impressed by the beauty and charm of Angela Vigerio, and he wants to marry her. And he also introduces his whole family to this Vigerio family. The family drives to the village in a model teapot, and Bayardo's mother is Alberta Simons, is a mulatto woman, and who in her youth had been proclaimed the most beautiful woman in the Angeles. That is, this the mother of Bayardo San Roman. And this Bayardo San Roman, he has two young sisters, And his father is very famous, General Petronius Andraman. He is a general and hero of the civil wars of the past century. So from these descriptions, we can identify that the families, that is Angela's families and Bayardo family, compared with the Angela's family, this Bayardo is from a very high class and a very from a very wealthy family. And Angela does not want to marry Bayardo. Actually, she does not like to marry this man. And Bayardo asks Angela what house she likes best. And she replies that she liked the farmhouse belonging to the widower Sias. And the widower insists that the house was not for sale, but Bayardo keeps offering more and money, more money until Sias gives in. That means to impress Angela, Bayardo, that is, offers more and more money to that widow and buys that farmhouse for Angela. That much he loves Angela. And nobody knows that Angela is not a virgin. And they have a huge wedding with extravagant gifts and days and nights of dancing and revelry. Yes. Nobody acknowledges that she is not a virgin, and without her consent and without her permission or something like that, this family decides to get ma decides to arrange the marriage between Angela and Bayardo and Roman. And the narrator says that he and his brother. Narrator, that is here unknown, that is anonymous narrator. Narrator and his brother Louis Enrique, also with another friend Christo Bayardo, were with the Santiago Nazar all the time at the church and after at the festival. That is here the narrator remembered her wedding day. That the narrator says that he and his brother Louis Enrique, along with the Christo Bayardo, along with the Santiago Nazar, all were at the church and after at the festival. And this narrator, he could not believe, and it was hard to believe that one of them, that is Santiago Nazar, could have such a big secret. That is, Angela Vigerio, she declares that Santiago Nazar is responsible for her disgrace. And this narrator, he was hard to believe that. And the narrator has a confused memory of the festival. And after the wedding function at 6 in the afternoon, the bride and groom take their leave and drive to their new house. The narrator, then his brother Louis, friends Cristo and Santiago all went to Maria Alejandra Cervantes' house that war. Where the Vigerio brothers also went and were singing and drinking. That is, after the wedding, this people all spend their time with the Maria. Then, after that, Puravio goes to bed at 11 o'clock and has fallen into a deep sleep when there is a knocking at the door. Yes, almost at the midnight. There is a knocking at the door, and she opens the door and sees Bayardo and Angela standing there. Bayardo pushes his wife into the house and thanking her for everything. After he leaves, Pura holds Angela's hair with one hand and beats her. And when the twins return home, Pedro asks Angela who has taken her virginity. She says it was Santiago Nazar. So, this is the summary of the chapter 2. Then, that means the important thing is that is Bayardo's and Raman, his arrival to that town, and the meeting between Bayardo's and Raman and Angela. Then his infatuation towards this Lady Angela, then their marriage, and after that, this Bayardo San Roman identified that she is not virgin, and he, yes, returned her to her own home. Then chapter 3. The Vigariotins later tell the narrator that they began looking for Santiago Nazareth Maria Alejandra Cervantes' place, where they had been with him until 2 o'clock. And since he was not there, they went to Clotilde Armenta's mill shop, which was near Santiago's house, to wait for him to come out. Yes. So in the previous chapter itself, these Brigadier brothers get the notion that it is Santiago Nazar who is responsible for her disgrace. So they decided to kill this man. So first, these Vigario Tin brothers, they began looking for Santiago Nazareth Maria Alejandra Cervantes, because after the wedding, these all people, they spent their time with this Maria. But since he was not there, they went to Clotilde Mill, Armenda's mill shop, and which was near to Santiago's house. After Angela Vigario reveals Santiago's name to her brothers, they immediately go to the pigsty and they pick out the two best knives, wrap them in rags, and have them sharpened at the meat market. When they identify, after Vigario, Angela Vigario reveals Santiago Nazar's name to her brothers, they decided to kill this man and they pick out two best knives, wrap them in rags, and have them sharpened at the meat market. And the butcher, that is Faustino, he wonders why they are coming. He thought they were so drunk that they did not know what time or what day it was. First of all, this butcher, he was surprised why they are coming in this time. He thought they were so drunk that they did not know what time or what day it was. They talk about the wedding and Pablo declares that they are going to kill Santiago Nazar. And to the butcher, this Pablo openly declares that they are going to kill this man, Santiago Nazar, because the twins are known to be good people. Nobody pays any attention to them. These brothers, they openly declared in public. They openly declared to the public, or to many people, that they are going to kill this man, Santiago Nazar. But nobody pays any attention to them because these twins are known to be good people by this in the society. After they leave, Faustino reports the conversation to a police officer who comes by. And after that, this Faustino doubts something and he reports this conversation to a police officer who comes by. At Clotilde Armendariz's milk shop, the twins drink two bottles of liquor and they also tell her that they are looking for Santiago to kill him. And once again, these twin brothers, they declared openly that they are going to kill this man. Clotilde tells her husband, Don Rogelio, but he responds that she is being silly. But Clotilde also, yes, responds or tells her husband that they told in this way, or they are going to kill this man, but he responds that she is being silly. At the same time, the police officer, that is butcher, also informs the same matter to the police officer, and the police officer informs to one colonel Lazaro Aponte about the Vigario brothers' plan. And the colonel hears that Angela Vigario had been brought home on her wedding night and realizes the connection between the event and the impending murder. Yes, colonel, he hears about that Angela Vigario's problem and realizes the connection between that event and the impending murder. So the colonel goes to Clotilde Armenta's shop, takes the knives away from these twin brothers and tells them to go home. He explains later that he thought the twins were, yes, bluffing, and he thinks that the problem will be solved. The Vigario brothers go home, get two different knives and go to have them sharpened. Once again, they went to home and they took another two knives and go to have them sharpened. And once again, this butcher Fosnoy is confused, believing that the boys have brought the same knives. Although Pedro makes the decision to kill Santiago, Pablo insists on following through with this plan. Yes, Pedro, who makes this decision to kill Santiago, and Pablo insists on that decision. Pablo Vigario's fiancée, that is Prudencia God, says she never would have married him if he had not upheld sister's honor by killing Santiago. This Pablo's fiancée Prudencia also insists him to protect her sister's honor. Otherwise, she won't marry. She would not marry Pablo. She waits the 3 years. He is in jail. This Prudencia Cortes, that is Pablo's fiancée, she waits 3 years for Pablo when he is in jail. And when he gets out, he becomes her husband for life. Because she wants to protect this Angela Vigario's honor. She insists that the one who is responsible for her decision, he should be killed. The twins go back to the milk shop. Their knives wrapped in newspaper from Prudencia's house. Clotilde Armende once again gives them a liquor, hoping to make them so drunk they can't do anything. That's why she gave them liquor. The narrator then describes Maria Alejandra Cervantes' house, where there are musicians, dancing courtyard, pleasurable mulatto girls. We know that it is a war house. So there are so many pleasurable items are there in Maria's house. And the narrator says it was Maria who did away with his generation's virginity. But on the night before the murder, Maria would not let Santiago dress up her mulatto girls as he usually did. So Santiago and Cristo, Bayardo and Louis Enrique and the narrator set off with the musicians on a round of serenades, etc. That is, here the narrator remembered the things that was happening yesterday, especially in the war house with Maria. And after that, they all go to get breakfast, but Santiago says he wants to get an hour of sleep before the bishop comes. And Clotilde Armende has told Father Carmen Amador about the Vigario's plan. First, this Clotilde tells her husband about this twin brother's plan, but he dismissed that, and that means he does not give much value to that thing. And once again, Clotilde Armende has told the same matter to Father Carmen Amador about the Vigario's plan. But because of the bishop's arrival, the father forgets, and on his way to meet the bishop's spot, walks right by the milk shop where the murderers are waiting. Yes. But this, I already told you in the first chapter, that particular day is very important for the people because bishop is coming to that town. So the father is very busy, and because of the bishop's arrival, and the father forgets this thing, and on his way to meet the bishop's board, actually he walks right by the mill shop where the murderers are waiting, but he forgets about what Clotilde Armenda tells to him. That means almost all people, that is that butcher, then this Clotilde Armenda, her husband, then of that police officer, that almost all people ignored about this impending murder. They did not give much attention to what these twin brothers are saying, that they openly declared that they are going to kill this man. Only Colonel, who gives some attention to this matter, and he reached there, and he thinks that everything will be solved. ऑलमोस्ट ऑल कैरेक्टर्स दे डिड नॉट गिव मच अटेंशन टू दिस मैटर. So at the end of the chapter 3, we can see that twin brothers, they are still waiting in the Clotilda's milk shop, and almost all characters they did not give much attention to this matter, that is that impending murder. That is the third chapter. I think all of you understand the summary of the third chapter. And students, there is a homework for you, and the homework is write a critical note on the chapter 2 and 3 of the novella Chronicle of a Death Foretold. Write your homework and send back to me. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you again.